Hey guys, we are Zach and Jody Gray, and we are here on location in Franklin, Tennessee, where we live. And today we are talking about one of the biggest tools that has allowed us to achieve a 3 to 5 hour workflow, and that tool is the ExpoDisc. The average wedding photographer in America spends 22 hours just editing their photos. Oh my gosh, that is a tremendous amount of time. So Jody and I are so excited that we've been able to streamline our workflow down to 3 to 5 hours so that we can do what everybody else wants to do, which is get their life back or actually spend time building their business. And when you're able to capture perfect color and perfect exposure in your camera, it can speed up your post-processing by a tremendous amount.
So in this first video, we're going to talk about why custom white balance and why use the ExpoDisc. This is the first of 5 videos, and we highly encourage you to watch all 5 videos, which will help answer many of the questions that you may have and help you use your ExpoDisc correctly so you can get awesome color and awesome exposure.
So white balance is simply the color of light, and as we all know, that light has a lot of different temperatures, literally thousands of different temperatures. So as you know, you can be in a reception hall and you can have that very orange tungsten light, and the camera's trying to balance that out and make all the whites actually look white. And inversely, we can be out on a cloudy day and we have this very blue shaded light, and the camera's trying to take that blue out and make the whites again look white. And there's also this other tricky little thing, which is that little tint slider. We have this purpley hue magenta tint and also this green hue that can be in all of the different temperatures and colors of light. So it can be very complex when it comes to getting the correct white balance.
So if you poke around inside your camera, you'll notice that there's different white balance settings. Probably the most commonly used is auto white balance. And this is where the camera is thinking on its own. And yes, we may have spent a good amount of money on our cameras, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they're smart.
All right. So the first white balance setting that we're going to talk about is auto white balance setting. And when you're using auto white balance, as you know, the camera is looking at whatever it sees and is trying to decipher exactly what the correct color is. The problem is, and as many of you have probably found out, your colors from shot to shot end up changing and kind of being all over the place. Sometimes they're a little too cold, maybe sometimes they're pretty close, maybe sometimes they're way too warm. And the problem is when we go into post-production, we're all over the place trying to adjust image by image and shot by shot. And more importantly, we're trying to get those skin tones of our clients looking natural. We need those natural skin tones.
So what we're going to do is we are going to bring in Meredith, our model, and we are going to take a shot. We're going to take a shot on auto white balance so you can see what the camera is going to do thinking on its own, and then we're going to take a shot with the custom color just so you can see the differences right now. And the next video will walk you through the actual steps of how you can get that custom white balance.
Love it.
The camera also has other white balance settings, from cloud to tungsten to fluorescent, and you can switch your camera to those, but the problem with that is they're just generally down the line. What if you're shooting outside with sun, but then you have some clouds rolling through? Or what if you're indoors and you have a warm light coming from here and a cooler light coming from there? What camera setting is that?
So you also have another option, which is Kelvin. So you can sort of go in the back of your camera and adjust all of these thousands of different degrees of temperature. And the problem is most of us probably haven't memorized every single Kelvin color, and we still have to know what the tint is. One option that you can do is you can look at the back of your camera and sort of adjust the Kelvin while you're looking at the image. But the problem is that little screen on the back of the camera, Jody and I like to say that it lies to you all the time. As many of you know, you think your images are just right and you get them home and look at them on the computer, and they're totally whacked. So the problem with the Kelvin is that it may look close, but every screen on the back of the camera is not a color calibrated monitor, and it looks different in different lighting situations, as many of you know. So Jody and I like to use custom white balance to get perfect custom color every time.
The camera is designed to read things in a certain way, and the one thing that the camera does understand is 18% gray. So if we can give it that 18% gray, then it can adjust all the other colors around it. The reds will be reds, the blues will be blues, and the skin tones will look amazing.
Yeah, so the ExpoDisc is absolutely awesome because it does 3 amazing things for us. One, unlike a traditional gray card, it's really easy to use by yourself. You simply slide it over your lens, which we're going to talk about in the next video. Number two is that it's super fast and efficient. It works literally in just, once you get it down, it works in just a couple of seconds. And three, it maximizes your post-production speed and gets you flying through post-production really, really fast. Because again, we're not trying to figure out what the color of each individual shot is, because this gives us that perfect color every single time.